Ever catch yourself scrolling through YouTube, searching for that one video that truly captivates you? It's not just boredom driving you. It's an innate urge to discover something new. As humans, we are wired to seek out knowledge, and our success as a species comes from this relentless pursuit. Since we can't always predict what information will be useful, we are never fully satisfied. We're always on the lookout for more. At the Academy of Useless Ideas, we believe learning happens naturally when curiosity is sparked. There's no need to force anyone into a subject. If something's interesting, people will dive in. With that idea in mind, today we present you with four reasons why we find number theory fascinating. Reason 1. Mathematics begins with numbers. Let's start at the very beginning. What is mathematics? If you have an answer, we'd love to hear it in the comments. But don't worry if you can't pin it down precisely. Like many profound concepts, mathematics is easier to recognize than to define. In any case, one thing we can all agree on is that mathematics begins with numbers. Once humans abstracted the concept of counting, their curiosity unlocked a metaphorical treasure chest rather than Pandora's box. Instead of chaos, this discovery revealed an intricate web of patterns and questions. Exploring this web has led to remarkable advances, such as the development of modern cryptography algorithms that secure our digital communications. These breakthroughs not only advance technology, but also enhance our daily lives in countless ways, demonstrating that the pursuit of mathematical understanding can have profound, tangible benefits for humanity. With the foundation of counting established, we naturally progressed to addition and multiplication. However, as we grew comfortable with these basic operations, new unexpected problems emerged, driving further mathematical exploration. To tackle these challenges, we expanded our number systems, first by introducing zero, then negative numbers, followed by rational numbers, real numbers, and eventually complex numbers. Each new type of number faced initial skepticism, but their proven usefulness led to their gradual acceptance and integration into mathematics. Zero, for example, once seemed nonsensical to earlier mathematicians, but now it's hard to imagine math without it. What about negative numbers or irrational numbers like a square root of 2? Each was once controversial. Yet today, they are fundamental. So, what kinds of numbers might seem strange or controversial now, but will be indispensable in the future? Perhaps studying number theory will give us clues about how number systems evolve and how we'll continue to invent new numbers to solve new problems. It's an exciting thought. The future of numbers might be just as surprising as their past. Reason 2. Number theory problems are amusing. We may not live to see the future of mathematics unfold, but even today there is so much about numbers we still don't understand. Take addition and multiplication. Most adults feel like they've mastered these basic operations. But dig a little deeper into the natural numbers, and you'll find that even the simplest number systems can be far more challenging than they seem. How hard can the natural numbers really be? You might ask that with a bit of pride, or maybe some skepticism. But number theory has a way of humbling even the most confident thinkers. To get a sense of how tricky these simple numbers can be, Let's consider three famous problems that start with nothing more than natural numbers. Problem 1. The McDowell's Nuggets problem. In an effort to revolutionize fast food, Cleo McDowell introduces McNuggets, chicken nuggets with sesame seeds, available in portions of 4 or 7. Now, here is the question. How many McNuggets can you buy using only these portion sizes? At first, you might play around with some combinations to figure out which totals are possible. But if the math bug has beaten you, you won't stop there. You'll want to abstract and generalize the problem. And before you know it, you'd be doing some number theory. You might realize that the total number of nuggets you can buy must take the form 4a plus 7b, where a and b are natural numbers representing how many portions of 4 or 7 you've chosen. But the mathematician in you won't settle for studying just this case. You'll want to go further. Given two numbers, m and n, how can you find all possible solutions of the equation c equal ma plus nb, where a, b, and c are natural numbers? Problem 2. How many prime numbers are there? A prime number is a natural number greater than 1 that can only be divided evenly by 1 and itself. Primes are like the building blocks of every number system. So it's natural to wonder, how many of these fundamental blocks exist? Early mathematicians, through some clever reasoning, discovered that there are infinitely many prime numbers. But we can refine this question further. How many primes are smaller than 100, or 1,000, or 1,000,000? More generally, for any number n, how many primes are smaller than n? You might try to answer this by brute force, writing a program that calculates every prime number smaller than n. But as n grows larger, this approach becomes less practical. The number of primes is unpredictable, and calculating each one quickly becomes a monumental task. Are we doomed to never know how often these building blocks appear? Thankfully, no. While finding the exact number of primes smaller than a given n is tough, mathematicians discovered a beautiful approximation known as the prime number theorem. Even better, this approximation becomes more accurate as n increases, giving us a powerful tool to understand the distribution of primes. It's a testament to the power of human ingenuity and one of the many jewels of number theory. Problem 3. Goldbach's conjecture. Do you find prime numbers fascinating or trivial? Either way, mathematicians are obsessed with them. But why? What makes primes so captivating? For me, it wasn't love at first sight. In school, I found primes to be neither particularly useful nor exciting. But as I delved deeper into mathematics, their strange properties and irregular patterns began to draw me in. There is something mysterious about primes, and despite their simplicity, they are incredibly difficult to fully understand. The fundamental theorem of arithmetic tells us that every number can be uniquely broken down into prime factors, making primes the building blocks of multiplication. But what about addition? Can prime numbers also serve as the building blocks there? The Goldbach conjecture proposes that every number greater than 2 can be written as the sum of, at most, 3 prime numbers. It sounds simple, right? And indeed, you can verify it for small numbers without much trouble. In fact, with the help of computers, the conjecture has been checked for numbers up to 4 times 10 to the power of 18. But even with such enormous verification, we still don't have a proof, and mathematicians remain undeterred by its practical uselessness. But why? It's because problems like Goldbach's conjecture taunt us with their simplicity. They remind us of how much we don't yet understand about numbers. This tantalizing mystery is part of what makes number theory so irresistible. Which brings us to our next reason to study it. Reason 3. Number theory connects to everything else in math. Since mathematics begins with numbers, it's no surprise that number theory touches every other branch of the subject. Numbers lie at the foundation of mathematical thought. And the deeper you explore number theory, the more you discover its connections to seemingly unrelated areas of mathematics. The famous mathematician Carl Friedrich Gauss once called mathematics the queen of the sciences, and number theory the queen of mathematics. He added, "She often condescends to render service to astronomy and other natural sciences, but in all relations, she is entitled to the first rank." Though it may sound pretentious, Gauss wasn't wrong. Problems in number theory frequently push other fields of mathematics forward, and in some cases, they even give birth to entirely new branches. Take Fermat's last theorem, for example. Solving this long-standing puzzle required mathematicians to develop entirely new areas of mathematics, like modern algebraic geometry. Or consider the advances in abstract algebra driven by attempts to better understand number theory. What begins as a study of simple numbers often leads to deep, abstract mathematical ideas. So, if parts of mathematics feel too abstract or disconnected, why not start with something as simple as counting? As history shows, a journey that begins with numbers can lead to surprising and delightful destinations. Reason 4. Real-world applications. At the Academy of Useless Ideas, we often revel in the abstract and the theoretical. But let's not kid ourselves. There is more to number theory than just elegant proofs and mind-bending puzzles. The truth is, number theory has some pretty significant real-world applications that prove it's not just for math nerds. Take cryptography, for instance. The art of encoding and decoding information relies heavily on number theory. Whether you are securing online transactions or keeping your personal data safe from prying eyes, number theory is the unsung hero behind modern encryption techniques. Without it, your online shopping might be a lot less secure. Then there are error-correcting codes, which are essential for making sure your digital communications come through loud and clear. Ever wonder how your texts and emails manage to stay intact despite transmission errors? Number theory plays a key role in developing algorithms that detect and correct those errors, ensuring that you receive your messages without a hitch. And let's not forget random number generation. From simulations in science and engineering to the randomness in your favorite games, number theory helps create sequences that are as random as they come, providing the unpredictability needed for everything from secure passwords to fair dice rolls. So, while we love diving into the theoretical aspects of number theory, it's nice to know that our mathematical adventures have practical impacts in the real world. If you are interested in math with tangible benefits, number theory is definitely worth your time. While we've explored 4 compelling reasons to dive into number theory, our list is far from exhaustive. Just as there are countless numbers, There are countless motivations for exploring this fascinating field. Your curiosity and personal interests might reveal entirely new reasons why number theory captures your imagination, or why it doesn't. So we want to hear from you. After all, our main goal is to foster independent thought. Do any of our reasons resonate with your own experiences or interests? Perhaps you have other intriguing reasons for studying or not studying number theory that we haven't covered. Sharing your thoughts can offer fresh perspectives and enrich the ongoing conversation about this captivating subject. Your curiosity is the driving force behind our exploration of number theory, and your insights make this journey even more exciting. So, don't hold back. Drop your thoughts in the comments and let's continue to discover the wonders of mathematics together. Until next time, stay mathy.